Step 1. Create biped. Go to create option and go to systems. Click on system and click on biped. Click and pull. Then right click to finish. Next, select any part of your biped and go to motion panel. In motion panel, you have options to adjust your biped. So click on figure mode and go to structure. In structure, you can make changes. So for example, right now your biped has only one finger on each hand. To change that, go to fingers and add 5, and then you can add more links. So let's add maybe 2 or 3 links. Next are feet. You can make adjustment here as well. So you have a 1, 2, 3 links. So I don't need 3 of them. I'll keep 1. And I can scale. So width and height. Now I can copy the same width and height from one toe to another. So to do that, go to copy and paste option, create new collection, copy, select opposite, and paste posture opposite. Okay, when you finish adjusting your biped, turn off figure mode. Make sure it's off. Next, select any part of your biped and click on footstep mode. Make sure walk is selected and then go to create multiply footsteps option. Click it and type how many steps you want. 6 will be enough. Click OK. So you can see your steps now, but nothing will happen because you need to activate it. To do that, go to footsteps option and click create keys from interactive footsteps. So click and notice your biped did change, and now when you play it, you can see your walking motion. Now we need to adjust this because you want a one walking cycle and you want to keep your biped in one place. To do that, you first turn off your footstep mode and you should see some keys. Next, we need to convert this to regular keys. So select whole biped. Okay, make sure this button is on. If it's not, just click it on and then select all biped. This is responsible for your back and forward movement. Then click convert option, keep it like that and click OK. Now we need to make adjustment to your walk cycle. You want a walk cycle that starts and ends with the same pose. So turn on the auto key and go to key info and find first pose. Something like this will be great, where both feet are on the ground. So this one will work for me. And click set key. When you do that, you can delete the keys in the front. And now we need to find the last pose. So starts with the purple leg. 1, 2, 3 and finish. And we kind of need to find similar pose. Make sure you click set key. If you don't, this will happen. So if I delete the keys, notice my pose got distorted. So hit Ctrl Z and set the key for all the body parts. And then go back and delete other keys. So click delete. Turn off the auto key for a second. Click, select all the keys and drag it to zero. Next, adjust the length of timeline. So to do that, click on time configuration, and my animation has 3 frames, so I put 3 here and click OK. So now we have our character walking. But we need to keep character in the same place to see if our animation is good. To do that, click Models, plus sign, and you see this in place mode. Click it and play your animation again. And you can notice there's a small difference between first and last pose. So we need to copy first pose and paste as last one. So stop your animation, make sure your whole biped is selected. Turn on auto key. Go to copy paste options. Okay. Create new collection. Change to pose. Copy the whole pose. Also, what you want to copy is vertical position. Okay. Up and down movement. So turn this on. Copy again. Make sure you are on the first pose. Copy. Go to the last pose and paste, and you can see small change. So let's play our animation again, and now it looks pretty good. So what we can do, we can convert this to the keyframes. So click generate keyframes per frame. Now when I play this animation, it's in one place, but if I shut down this button, my biped will keep walking forward. To make better adjustment, what I need to do, I need to create new layer, okay, and make it adjustments. So I go to layers, open layer menu, and click create new layer. Next thing, I'll set up my biped on my first keyframe and move it so it's on the middle. Okay. Next, I'll copy and paste this keyframe. So, again, I go to copy and paste options. Okay. I copy and paste both horizontal and vertical position. So, I select both arrows, click copy, go to the end, and paste. Okay. So now my character working in the same place. So that's my new animation, that's my old animation. Next, I can go and collapse both layers. Or I can add more layers to it. So if you want to make additional adjustments, maybe add a little bit movement to the head, I can add more layers. So I collapse for now. Okay. You can see that the in-place mode is off. And I play my animation and I have my character walking in one place.